day in the life of your favorite YouTuber. It just cannot get any better than that.
啊，你好，要一个猪肉吧。
猪肉。
对。
喂，你好，2.8元。
好的。你是谁啊？在这儿。
Right, I'm at the university gates. I've got to scan through Goose Security and then we'll be there.
Ah, 谢谢。
All right, we finally made it onto campus. Unfortunately, it's the wrong campus. So I now have to take the university bus to the other campus because this is in downtown. This is Shuhui campus in the middle of Shanghai, my campus where I study.It's in the outskirts, it's really far away. I didn't want to live over there because it's just, there's not much going on and there's more to do over here. I only have to go to university a couple times a week, so there's no point really. All right, so this time I really have arrived and this,is Shanghai Jiao Tong University, where I'll be for the next 3 years. So because of the schedule of the buses, I'm here a little bit early. So right now I'm gonna go to the library, study there for an hour or so. I had a Chinese class last night, so I'm just gonna recap on what I did. Alright, so I'm currently a second year PhD student here and my research focuses on building AI, artificial intelligence models to help detect cancer at an earlier stage, so it will help with any false negative diagnoses. So as part of my PhD program, I have to attend like 30 or so seminars. What I'm going to right now is exactly to do with what I'm doing, so it's on deep learning. The problem is though, is that this one is all in Chinese, so a lot of it will go over my head because there's so many technical terminologies that I don't know. Alright, sweet. So lessons are over. I'm going to get some lunch now. I'm going to meet my friend Abdullah. I'm going to go to his lab. We'll walk over there together. Okay, so I'm with Abdullah at the moment. Here he is. He's also from the UK. He's in his second year of his PhD. So my degree, though, is really theoretical. I'm always reading books, I'm coding behind a computer. But Abdullah, I think his is a lot more practical. What do you study again? I forget.
So I'm a synthetic biologist. So surely some of you might have heard about CRISPR-Cas. I try to make new kind of tools that are not generally present in nature.
Goes over my head, but he's a smart guy. So you also studied in the UK for your masters. Which do you prefer? Do you prefer studying in China or do you prefer studying in the UK?
It really depends on what you're looking for. If you're gonna be like workaholic and probably gonna be on the table all the time doing lab work, China's the best place because you're gonna learn lots of skills. But in UK, you find answers yourself. It's good for learning, but if you want quick learning, China's a better place. The work environment is far different than the UK. The first day I came here and I left at about like 5 or 6, and I was surprised that every single person was still doing their work, still head down on the table. And then probably a few days later, I went back at about 8 or 9 because I was feeling like a bit awkward trying to leave so early because I thought maybe I'm doing something wrong. Then I realized that no matter what time I'm leaving, they're still there. If you really love working and you love what you're doing, you're probably okay with China. So yeah, China's better.
Yeah, there we are. China's better. Sense. Come to China. Come study in China.
You know how to pay here?
Go. By the way guys, if you haven't already, then please do subscribe to this channel. It would really mean a lot. I'm only a tiny, 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 tiny YouTube account at the moment. I can't even monetize my videos because I don't think I've got enough subscribers. So all of this is done for free. So leave a like and a comment as well. I'll try and reply to all comments. Campuses in the West are honestly so small. Back in the UK when I was studying for my masters, you could probably walk around the whole place in 15 or 20 minutes, for example. But here, it's a completely different ball game. Honestly, it is gigantic. You're gonna be walking for a good 2 or 3 hours if you wanna explore the whole of this place, which makes it really fun. There's so much to do here. But fortunately, on campus, we have some of these beauties. Let me show you. It is ridiculously convenient to use. You just get your phone out, you scan it, and you're good to go. And it is so cheap as well. It's probably 10 RMB for an hour, which is less than $1, I think. Right, this is where the boring stuff happens, I'm afraid. So I've now got to go to my research lab, do work for an hour or so because I've got a couple of meetings to prepare for. So first of all, I have to meet my professor, just go over my research, how it's gone every week. So he'll tell me if I'm in the right direction or not, probably not. And then I have to give a presentation to my classmates. that's pretty much the end of my day at university. I'm going to be heading back home on the bus. And yeah, it's the weekend, so I can relax a little bit. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys next time.